Hi, I'm going to show you now how we use PyCharm and how we'll be using it for this class. PyCharm is a code editor. So like we have Microsoft Word for writing documents, and we have Excel for working with spreadsheets, and you have some email client that you use for your email. They've written programs for working with code. And PyCharm is one specifically designed for code written in Python, which is the language we're using in this course. And you'll download PyCharm and install it as part of your homework, and you'll be using that this semester. So I'm going to show you how that works. So here I have PyCharm open on my computer. It'll look pretty similar if you're running on Windows. There's a few basic parts to PyCharm that you should be aware of. And so first, here on the left is what we call the folder tree or the directory. And so it shows you all the different files that you have, files and folders in your project. You'll be making a single project for this class. We'll prompt you to call it CS110, and that will be your project route for the rest of the semester. All the work that you do will now go in that folder, right? So here I have a folder. I've called it Winter 2023, I've got all the folders and files I'm going to need. Here's just a few of them for now. But you can see inside my Winter 2023 folder, I have another folder, which is my Getting Started folder. And in that folder, I have a single Python file. And so this panel on the left is like using Finder if you're on a Mac, or File Explorer if you're on Windows. It's just a built-in file browser right here inside the editor. I can double-click on one of these files, like hello.py, and it will open it up. Open it up here in the panel we call the editor view. And so here I have a little tab for hello.py. If I open up more than one file, so let's say I make a new file. So I'm going to come over here to my lecture folder, right click, new Python file. I'm going to say another Python file.py. You'll see that it creates these little tabs here, just like in your web browser, right? Multiple tabs. And so this is the panel where you do all your coding. You type the code, right? So right now I have this line, print hello. Nice little Python script, very simple, right? You could probably guess what this is going to do. Another feature that we will be using in PyCharm is the ability to run a Python script right from your editor. And so if I right click on my editor over here, I can come down here and say run hello. Or I can also come up here, it says current file, and I can hit the run button there and run hello. I could even come over here in the file browser, right click, and run hello. Right. So there are many ways to run the script. You pick the one, you know, you'll use them all, I'm sure, at some point. But when you run it, this extra panel pops up down at the bottom. The run panel says, hey, you just ran hello, and this is what happened. And so there's some extra information here about what was going on to actually make it run. But the key idea is that it printed hello, and then it finished. Exit code 0 means there were no problems. Zero problems, and so all worked great. That's the basics of how to run a program. So I can close this out. I can just hit the little hide button here and hide it, and it goes away until I decide to run it again, right? Right click, run. There it is, hello. Thank you, close that out. You can, of course, edit your script. So I'm gonna copy that line, print it out again, print out hello, I'm so excited for this class. Something like that, right? Sometimes overenthusiasm maybe isn't virtue, but we'll run it anyway, right? Run, hello, hello, hello. So excited for this class. Right. So it gives you an idea of how you'll be using PyCharm to organize your files, edit your files, and then run your files. Those are the key ideas. There will be other things that we'll teach throughout the class, but this should be enough to get you started. Once you've downloaded one of the zip files that has the lab or homework assignment. You'll put that in your main CS110 folder, open up PyCharm, and away you go. Again, if you have questions, reach out to the TAs, reach out to me, and let's keep you going. Thank you very much.